Boxing Classic, George, is in the 132-pound division. Julius LeGrand from Cleveland trains at the Old School Boxing Club, where working in his corner tonight is Romeo Connors. Blaise Santarello is his opponent from Pittsburgh, 5'7", 20 years old. He's an electrician. He's been boxing for 2 years. It'll be interesting to see how this fight shapes up. Of course, LeGrand is in the Cleveland top with the orange trunks. Santarello is in the yellow trunks with the black trim.
Both fighters evenly matched. Height-wise, they're just about 2 inches apart. Weight, they're fairly even. Age-wise, they're almost exact. Both have been boxing about 2.5 years. Santarello's had a little more success with respect to formal titles. Both are orthodox-style fighters. And they both like Mike Tyson and Oscar De La Hoya.
So LeGrand showing good foot movement early on in this fight. It definitely seems like he does have the foot speed advantage in this fight. Nice left hook lands upstairs for Santarello.
Santarello, at least in his first round, is appearing that he's more of a power puncher type boxer. Sometimes that's not too good to be that in the amateurs. He's looking to really pick his shots out, where the more punches you throw in the amateurs, a lot of times the more success you have.
Both fighters using the jab right now, trying to set something else up. LeGrand lands nice jab to the body, followed by left hook upstairs.
LeGrand is scoring points. LeGrand's fighting a very nice first round. He's feeling out his opponent, seeing where his strengths and weaknesses are. There's a little bit of redness under Santarello's eyes right now from the jabs.
And Santarello's got LeGrand back up against the ropes briefly in the corner and let LeGrand out scot-free. Nice jab upstairs from LeGrand.
LeGrand has a very nice jab, and he has a very nice motion when he's going to the body. He doesn't take his eyes off his opponent. They still look each other right in the face, so the opponent's thinking he's coming with a facial jab, and he tricks him, more for lack of a better word, and gets him into the body.
So first round is complete. Let's go into the corner of Julius LeGrand, where working his corner is Romeo Connors.
Listen, you're seeing what you want to see, right?
You see what you got to
do. Slow. Okay. All you got to do is keep your back off the rope, start countering the shots that you make. Make you see that slow hook you find, and you take a step back. Don't step back too far. Step back just a half step so you can counter with the right hand. Left hook. Start putting them together on him now. Then when you get close inside, what you good for? Start doing it. Okay, do that. Start putting it together. Now, that was the first round. You done got loose. You done took a look at him. Now ain't no more looking. Start letting him go, all right? Let's do this, man. One upset.
Okay, you're too strong for him. The first shot you hit him with hurt him. Okay, fight good. Okay, keep it up.
So round two set to begin here at Cleveland Brown Stadium. It's the first annual Brown and Orange Turnpike Boxing Classic. Julius LeGrand in the orange trunks, Blaise Santarello in the yellow and black trunks.
Julius LeGrand is going back to what he started in the first round. He's using his jab, he's bobbing and weaving, keeping himself out of danger and also trying to score points at the same time. He has excellent footwork for a gentleman that's only been in boxing for 2.5 years.
A lot of that credit has to go to his training there at Old School Boxing Club.
Old School Boxing Club is a legendary gym in the city of Cleveland, arguably the best.
Nice right hand upstairs lands for LeGrand. LeGrand tries the right hand again. Santarello is able to shake that off.
Maybe it's something in the water here, Antonio, but the Cleveland fighters so far are dominating the Pittsburgh fighters.
Oh, I talked to him earlier today, George, and they were basically saying that there was no competition between the Cleveland guys and the Pittsburgh guys. There really isn't. The Pittsburgh guys really aren't known as good boxers, and the city of Pittsburgh isn't really known as a boxing hotbed, as Cleveland is and has been in the last, really, 5 years, a really dominant force in the amateurs.
Cleveland's been a boxing tradition for many, many years, and the guys that are working this fight tonight are good people, and they've done a lot for this sport and really have put Cleveland on the map.
And Santarello has LeGrand backed up in the corner, does a nice job to spin out of that corner, does LeGrand, and get back into the center of the ring where he obviously feels more comfortable and he can use that hand and foot speed as well. Get tied up in the referee there quickly. breaks the two men. Short left uppercut missed from LeGrand, and again, referee Earl Jewell is going to have the fighters break. And round two is in the books. George, an evenly matched fight, both fighters having their way with one another at different points during the fight. LeGrand obviously has that speed advantage. It appears that Santarello is trying to get his power shots to take that speed away from LeGrand, though.
LeGrand is, I think, winning the fight. He's thrown more punches in bunches, score points in the amateur ranks. Santarello, though, could be calculating something for the third round. Those shots are hard shots. Can break anybody down if you have enough of them hit you. This round is going to really show LeGrand's training, his conditioning, and did he get up at 5:30 and do his road work?
It's one of the major differences, George, between scoring in the amateur, scoring in the professionals. You're basically not scored as a whole entire round as to who won that round and who doesn't in the amateurs. Whenever you land a punch, you score a point. Whoever has the most points at the end of the fight is the winner.
Sometimes that's a harder way to score a fight, and sometimes it's an easier. And just like in the pros, you have judges on each side of the ring, so there's many different views. From our perspective, it's one view, but another judge could see it another way, and the viewers at home could see it a third way.
Both fighters heating up again in this third round. LeGrand working the jab, and Santarello effectively working the body.
Santarello just landed a very nice body shot to LeGrand. Didn't seem to have too much effect on him, but it did score a few points.
And as both fighters are in the center of the ring, it would appear that LeGrand would have the advantage, and he's choosing to slug a little bit with Santarello. Maybe he's felt his power and feels that he can take his power. Nice left hook upstairs lands for LeGrand, but maybe he thinks he felt his power, and now he can stand toe-to-toe with him and work his own power shots.
Both fighters are standing toe-to-toe, and both fighters can take a punch. Those are some hard shots that are landing right now, and it doesn't seem to have much effect on them physically.
This right cross lands for Santarello. Left hook upstairs lands for LeGrand. Appears to slow down Santarello as he kind of stopped in his tracks for a second. But LeGrand did not capitalize and go after Santarello when it appeared he had him maybe for a split second shaken up.
The fighters are getting a little bit tired trying to finish the fight. LeGrand's maybe being a little cautious right now. Maybe he felt a couple of those shots and realized he was ahead on points.
Left hook to the body scores for LeGrand. Down goes Santarello. First knockdown of the fight. And that's going to do it. Earl Jewell has called this off. Santarello would be unable to continue. Julius LeGrand started the fight as a more of a boxer-puncher. The third round went into puncher-boxer mode. Landed the big left hook to the body. Santarello was unable to get up from that perfect left hook shot.
You're exactly right. Boxer puncher to puncher boxer. And we're going to hear from Julius LeGrand in a few moments.
So that's a very impressive stoppage there for Julius LeGrand as he was working his speed in the beginning of the fight, then just went to a whole new style. I feel was able to feel Santarello's punches early on, felt that he could take his punches, whatever he could land, and counter with hard shots of his own, which he did, which resulted in that big left hook to the body scoring and stopping Blaise Santarello.
I just want to know one thing. One question to ask you, man, as your trainer. What took so long?
I don't know.
What took so long? That's the only thing I got to ask you. What took so long?
I don't know. I was waiting a lot.
Let's take it up to our ring announcer, Bob Dobies, for the official particulars on who won this match.